In today's video, we're going to take a look at force click as well as haptic feedback with the trackpad on a Mac. This is specifically done with any Mac that has a trackpad, or if you have an external trackpad, you'll be able to use this feature as well. Now, if you find this tip useful, take a look at the end of the video. I'll have my little introduction of who I am at the end of the video instead of at the beginning of the video. All right, let's take a look at force click and haptic feedback on the Mac. Let's go over to my Mac. So what is a force click? Well, let's go over to this PDF here. When I just tap on it with the trackpad or click with the trackpad, it selects it. This is what we're used to. But what we can also do is a force click, and this is on by default. When we do a force click, what we're able to do is actually do a quick look with this. So how do we do a force click? Well, all we have to do is just press a little bit harder on the trackpad. And when you do, you're going to actually feel two clicks. The first click, when we select it, and then press a little bit harder and you'll feel a second click. And then you're going to see quick look, which gives us a quick look of this document here. So let's go ahead and click on it. And then I press a little harder. There's another click. And now we can see we're in quick look. So I can take a look at this PDF. I can interact with it. It's just like going to the spacebar. If I select it here and then tap on the spacebar, I get my quick look. Well, we get the same thing with force click. I don't have to tap the spacebar. We go over to the screenshot here. I just click and then press a little harder. There is my screenshot opening up with quick look. Now, we also have data detectors in here, so we can look up items. I'm going to open this up. I just double click on it and it opens up. So let's say I wanted to look up the word here, membership. Well, what I do is I double click on it. And now what I do is I do a force click. So I press a little bit harder. So I click and then click again, or press a little harder again. I don't double click. All I do is just once and then I press a little harder. And you're going to see that it is pulling up lookup information. I can do that with any text. So we can go over here to this. And now I click and then force click, press a little harder, and we have our lookup. With media, you also have media controls by using force click. Now, if you don't like this, what I used to do is I used to recommend people turn this off, because when you want to drag something, let's say I wanted to drag this into a folder. Well, when you click and drag and you press a little harder, it opens up quick look. Now, Apple's gotten a lot better with the force click, but in the past, with some of the trackpads that you have out there, when you go and click on this, it was pretty easy to do that force click, and you couldn't really drag it. You just all of a sudden kept going into that quick look, so you couldn't drag it. So what I recommend people do was turn that off, so then you no longer have that force click. So how do you do that? If you wanted to try it without force click, maybe you're not using force click. Well, to turn it off, what we need to do is we need to go to our system settings. So I'm going to go over here to my system settings here. And then what we do is we go down to the bottom and you're going to see trackpad. When I select trackpad, we go over to point and click. It opens up to this by default. And then what you're going to see is force click and haptic feedback. If you no longer want to use it, all you have to do is just turn this off. You know, you can also turn off the lookup and data detector. So you're going to see that it is set to force click with one finger. What I can do is I can turn this off as well. When I turn this off, I will no longer be able to look up and use the data detectors. Now, ironically, when I turn this off here, and you can see that I also have force click on, I can also no longer use quick look. So when I click on this and I click again, you're going to see that it is no longer using that quick look. I can't open up that PDF. So in addition to look up and data detectors, this also controls the quick look. So now when I click and then press, we get my quick look. So even though it's not labeled there, it does control that. So that is how you use force click on the Mac. Now, if you like what you see here, you may want to check out my site, dancetutorials.com. I have over 2,000 of these videos for the Mac, iPad, iPhone, Apple Watch, Apple TV, and I'm starting to add them for the Apple Vision Pro. In addition to that, when you become a member, you are helping support a small business. I just have this sitting, or I record these in a studio that is in a second bedroom in my house, and you're going to get the videos ad-free. There are no ads when you become a member, and you're also going to get access to my AI assistant, which is modeled after an Apple genius. So if you like what you see here, you may want to check out my membership options. Just go over to danstutorials.com. So that's a little bit about me and how you use force click on the Mac.